Hello everyone, welcome back to C-Vision Productions YouTube channel. Back in March of 2022, we uploaded our show BNSF Crossing the Cornbelt, the Marshall Subdivision. We had such a great response to that show that we decided to upload our second volume. It covers the same line, but with new trains and some different locations. Trains in this program were captured in 1996 and 1997, so lots of BN Cascade Green and clean Santa Fe war bonnets are featured. So enjoy over an hour and a half of the early days of BNSF in Crossing the Corn Belt, Volume 2. And please don't forget to hit that subscribe button. We'd love to have you come back to our channel again. The Marshall Subdivision of the Burlington Northern Santa Fe is not a super busy mainline, but is nonetheless a very important link from the southern and northern markets in the upper Midwest. In our first volume of Crossing the Corn Belt, we introduced to you the Marshall Sub from Willmar, Minnesota to Sioux City, Iowa. In this presentation, we will revisit the line, this time starting in Sioux City and touring our way north. We will look at new run-bys and some local work, most of which are shot in different locations. Just coming off the Sioux City sub from Ashland, Nebraska, train XSTL-WLM, which is a St. Louis to Willmar empty grain train, enters the 18th Street Yard in Sioux City. The yard is the beginning of the Marshall sub as it runs north. Crew changes are made at the yard along with locomotive fueling and minor maintenance. Just leaving the yard and heading south onto the Sioux City sub, train GJARWOI begins its trip to Lincoln. This loaded grain train originated in Garretson, South Dakota, and will end up at Woodlawn, Illinois. The lead unit on this train is a Santa Fe GP60M. Since the merger, these units are finding their way on many BNSF freights in the northern Midwest. Thank you. Just west of the small town of Hinton, a local just finished his daily work and is now heading back to the 18th Street yard. Many small industries and grain elevators along the line are served by the railroad every day. Rolling by the large elevators in Hinton, two Santa Fe Jeeps lead an empty grain train from Kansas City. A loaded coal train with symbol CATM-SUD is led by a trio of SD70 Mags. It is crossing over the Illinois Central Diamonds at Wren. This train was loaded at Antelope Mine in Wyoming and is heading to Superior, Wisconsin. In Superior, the coal will be transloaded onto a lake vessel and travel across Lake Superior to the Detroit Edison Power Plant in St. Clair, Michigan. Train ESUD-ATM is an empty coal train running through Merrill. Led by an SD60M, this train operates with the same symbol as the last one, only that this one is an empty, headed west to the mines for loading. The train was in the siding for the loads we've seen previously. Since the line is not CTC, All trains that take sidings for meets have to operate the switches manually. General operations for aligning the switches is for the conductor to operate both switches by hand. When the train leaves the siding, the engineer will pull his train onto the main line, then make a reverse movement to pick up the conductor after he realigns the switch. After the reverse movement is made, the train is underway and heads towards Sioux City for a crew change. Just to the south of Sioux Center, we find train MKCK-NTW1, a Kansas City, Kansas to Northtown manifest. Led by an SD40-2 and a Santa Fe GP30, this train will end up at Northtown Yard in Minneapolis. From there, each of the cars will be divided up at the hump and placed onto its respective train. In the heart of Sioux Center, a rock train from Willmar to Lincoln highballs past the old depot. The manifest train we saw earlier crosses over one of two bridges that loop over US Highway 75 in western Iowa. Train MLIN-NTW is another train bound for Northtown Yard, this one originating in Lincoln, Nebraska. This is the most common train on this line and is crossing milepost 164 just south of Dune. The sun gives us a spectacular setting in the western horizon as we wait for an oncoming train. A little light is left for us to view a Santa Fe SD40-2 as it leads an empty Houston to Willmar grain train through Dune and over the Rock River Bridge. In the tiny town of Alvord, we find train XSPMWLM1 with an aid of an Illinois Central SD40-2. This string of empty grain hoppers originated in Springfield, Missouri, and it's on its way to Willmar to be divided up. Just to the north of Lester, we catch up to another Sioux City to Sioux Falls local, led by a GP15-1. Making its way across the Minnesota-Iowa border on a cold March afternoon is a Northtown to Lincoln manifest. Thank you. Through the town of Hills, Minnesota, we see one of few high-priority Northtown to Kansas City, Kansas manifest trains. As with normal manifest trains receiving an M at the beginning of its symbol, the high-priority trains are designated with an H. On an early December morning, just as the sun breaks the horizon, we catch a meet between a coal and a grain train in Hills. The coal train arrived sooner than expected and had to wait on the main for the other train to clear the siding. Getting underway, the set of four locomotives heave the string of loaded coal past the grain train on its way north. Loads of coal are destined to Dairyland Power Co-op in Alma, Wisconsin. Thank you. Backtracking to Lester, we catch up to the grain train as it highballs at top speed on its way to Sioux City. Train carry symbol GGARWOI1. If you remember, that is the same symbol the second train in this video had. It carries loaded grain bound for Woodlawn, Illinois from Garretson, South Dakota. Back in Hills, we set up camp at the large elevators north of town. This is a common sight along this line as agriculture stands tall in the economic development of the Midwest. It is late August and the corn has grown to full size and will soon be ready to harvest. Running railroad east or southbound, train MNTWLIN1 heads to Sioux City after it picked up a string of ballast hoppers in Garretson. The GP28M, with a special Operation Lifesaver logo, heads the Sioux City to Sioux Falls local east of Manly. It will spot cars in Manly and Garretson before calling it a day in Sioux Falls. After the crew completes its work, they head north to Garretson. Another Detroit Edison coal train, this one led by a C-30-7, had just crossed under Interstate 90 and is about to cross the South Dakota border. Thank you. The GP39M leads a grain train to Garretson through the old railroad town of Bouge. Just north of our last location, a GP39E pulls train MLIN-NTW1 over a county road overpass. In the city of Garretson, a loaded grain train starts south after picking up several cars. It will stop again in Hills before making its way to Sioux City for a crew change. We will once again take a look at the Garretson branch line from Garretson to Sioux Falls and a peek beyond through Harrisburg. Besides the local train from Sioux Falls, nicknamed the Twister, a few run-through trains have started making their way over the branch line as well. We will see a mix of both in this segment. One of the run-throughs makes its way off the Marshall sub onto the branch line. A cold October rain pelts our camera as we catch this Sioux City to Sioux Falls empty grain train. Twister is now ready to depart Garretson after completing its work in the yard. After getting a track warrant from the dispatcher, it starts south to Sioux Falls. The lead unit on this train is an ex-Conrail GP38-2, which is now owned by EMD and leased to the BNSF. At the same location, we view another twister heading south on a cold winter afternoon. An old GP20 leads another twister over a county road overpass north of Corson. The Garretson branch line ends in Sioux Falls. With a population of over 100,000, it is the largest city in South Dakota. The twister makes its way past Weber Siding and will spot its cars on the Madison branch line. After setting out its freight, the power heads back to the depot awaiting its next assignment. In the meantime, the SW1200 switcher is hard at work switching cars for the second twister to run to Garretson in the afternoon. Usually two twisters run daily to Garretson and back, with others occasionally operating to Canton on the Canton sub and to Madison on the Madison sub. Canton Twister is seen leaving Sioux Falls with one load to Harrisburg. After spotting the empty grain hopper, the power heads back to Sioux Falls to prepare for another trip to Garretson. We are now back in Corson. It is here where we catch up to another run through terrain. The train is led with an SD75M locomotive. It is a loaded grain train from Sioux Falls to Pasco, Washington. The Sioux Falls to Pasco train is now arriving in Garretson, where it will exit the Garretson branch and head north onto the Marshall sub. After stopping in Garretson, the grain train awaits a power move to Sioux City. The power came off a train that went dead in Garretson a few hours earlier. With a Santa Fe SD75M leading the way, this loaded grain train for Kalama, Washington starts out of Garretson on a foggy morning. The train was stopped for a few minutes for a welding crew that had to fix a broken rail. An ex-Frisco GP50 in BN paint is now lettered for the Indiana and Ohio Railway. It is in charge of a Kansas City, Missouri to Northtown train through Garretson. Listen as the BNSF dispatcher gives this train a track warrant.
This will be track warrant 4072-4072, IORY 3104-3104, west to BST, mile post 131-131. Xbox 1 ONE, track warrant 4063-4063 is void. Xbox 2 TWO, proceed from mile post 131-131 to mile post 125-125 on main, MAIN track. Xbox 15, 1-5, flag protection not required against following trains on same track. Dispatcher OES, over.
Sitting on the border of South Dakota and Minnesota is the tiny town of Sherman. Yet another link into Northtown terrain makes an appearance with an LMX-839B on the point. A twin set of Dash 9s cut through Sherman and will be crossing the South Dakota-Minnesota state line just beyond our camera location. This train carries the symbol XSTLWLM1, an empty grain train from St. Louis to Willmar. The train will be stopping in Island, just up the line, to pick up additional cars. We will catch up to the westbound in a little while to view the switching. In the same location, but from the opposite direction, we catch train UBRMAJS. This is one of few taconite trains from the Iron Range of Minnesota that operates on the Marshall Sub. The taconite pellets are bound for the Union Pacific in Hastings, Nebraska. From there, the train will travel to a steel mill in Utah. Thank you. have now caught up to the St. Louis to Willmar grain train. It is now an island where it is picking up additional empty hoppers that were left on the siding. The 2-9 locomotives separate from the existing train and head down the main line to enter the siding. The engines couple onto the cars to be placed on the existing train. Due to yard congestion in Marshall and Willmar, the locals spotted these cars here for this train to take care of after the congestion eases. The twin set of Dash 9s are wearing the Heritage paint scheme, often referred as the Pumpkin paint scheme. These locomotives were delivered in 1997, with many more on the way. Coupling the extra hoppers with the rest of the train, the 1099 eases forward to the end of the siding. The St. Louis to Willmar grain train doesn't make it very far, however, as it must wait for another set of pumpkins pulling train MNTW-LIN-1 south to Lincoln. Yet another massive grain elevator sets adjacent to the line. This one is at a point called Split Rock, just south of Pipestone. The local switcher just finished moving a set of cars, and the crew abandons the train for lunch. The taconite train we saw earlier gracefully rolls past the massive elevator. Six LRCX SF30Cs are pulling this unit grain train north to Willmar. This train hasn't traveled very far yet. It's just picked up the cars at the Split Rock elevator and is bound for Pasco, Washington. The locomotive reporting marks are from the Livingston Rebuild Center in Livingston, Montana. This Northtown to Kansas City, Kansas manifest is north of Ruthin. 7,000 foot siding at Ruthin is a busy one. Many meets are made here, but this train has the clear and will not need to stop. Yet another Lincoln to Northtown train shows off a variety of power as it approaches the community of Florence. An Oakway SD60 leads an empty Wisconsin Power and Light coal train under the US Highway 14 overpass. This train will reload its hoppers at the Caballo mine just south of Gillette, Wyoming. Santa Fe -944CW is the locomotive of choice to lead this Lincoln to Northtown train through Russell. All is quiet and normal in the tiny town of Lind as people go about their everyday tasks. But every once in a while, the thunder of a train interrupts the tranquility for just a couple minutes. The hometown of the subdivision is next. The Marshall Depot is still used by yard crews. A local from Willmar to Sioux Falls sports a fine-looking GP10 as it works the yard to pick up a few cars. After the local clears, train XMAD-WLM-1 comes from the south. This train originated in Madison, Illinois, which is just across the river from St. Louis. As soon as the empty grain train clears, the local gets a warrant and heads south to Sioux Falls. Thank you. Right behind the local comes a new train to this subdivision. HNTW-BAR-1 is a high priority manifest from Northtown Yard in Minneapolis to Barstow, California. This train started this route on December 15, 1997. At the time of this production, three of these trains per week are scheduled to leave the Minneapolis yard. The Northtown to Barstow manifest will take a total of just under 90 hours to complete its journey to California. After completing a day of work on the hill in Granite Falls, a rail grinder makes its way through Green Valley. It will be stopping in Marshall to call it a day before working south again tomorrow. Another Sioux Falls to Pasco grain train makes its way through Cottonwood. The Dash 9 leading this train is adorned in the Santa Fe War Bonnet paint scheme. Henley Falls is host to some railroad history. It is here that a railroad Y was constructed connecting the Great Northern and the Minneapolis and St. Louis Railway. In 1901, the U.S. Supreme Court ordered the construction of a transfer track to interchange trains from one line to the other and was the first such transfer in the United States. The line heading west off the Marshall Sub is the XM and St. L line that is now the Henley Falls branch to Madison, Minnesota. The branch is now served by the BNSF. At the Y, we catch an Aberdeen, South Dakota to Chicago grain train picking up an extra unit for its train. The crew is picking up a Santa Fe cabless SD40-5. It is only one of three that the Santa Fe rostered. Thank you. the locomotives back on the train, the crew heads south. This particular train normally runs on the Morris and Wayzata subs to Minneapolis, then on its way to Chicago. It was unknown why the train was routed onto the Marshall sub. Just to the south of Granite Falls, one can get a spectacular view of the Minnesota River Valley. It is the first week in October and the leaves are just starting to show their fall colors. Before it stopped in Hanley Falls, we caught the Aberdeen to Chicago grain train as it climbed up the hill south of Granite Falls. Heading over US Highway 212 in Granite Falls, a local gained speed for his climb up the hill. Although it is not in its original location, the old Granite Falls Milwaukee Road Depot still stands today. Passing the old Burlington Northern Depot in Granite Falls is the Sioux Falls to Pasco train we saw in Cottonwood. At the Willmar Yard, this Lincoln to Northtown train just came off the Marshall sub and is about to stop at the east end of the yard. The Sioux City crew will soon be relieved by a fresh Willmar crew who will take the train to Northtown Yard via the Wayzata sub. Getting underway, a Willmar to Sioux Falls local progresses through a series of switches that will take the train out of the Willmar yard and onto the Marshall sub. The engineer is stopping his train to allow the conductor to board the caboose. Although not used on regular freights, cabooses are common on the locals. It allows the conductor to realign switches on the main after the switch work has been accomplished, thus saving time so that the engineer doesn't have to make any reverse movements to pick up his crew member. Since a majority of the trains on the Marshall sub originate or terminate at Northtown Yard in Minneapolis, we thought we should take you there to view the yard. So we will follow a couple trains along the way on the Wayzata sub. The Lincoln to Northtown train we saw earlier just received a new crew and is heading out of Willmar over US Highway 71. Moving on to the community of Howard Lake, we see that small town Minnesota life is still quiet and peaceful. The lake still remains frozen over, but will soon thaw since this scene was shot in early March. A snow squall surprises us as a Northern States Power coal train thunders through Howard Lake. We are now at the large yard in Minneapolis, named Northtown Yard. The yard is located a few miles north of downtown. Many railroads visit this yard besides the three BNSF subdivisions that run from Minneapolis. Canadian Pacific, Canadian National, Wisconsin Central, Twin Cities and Western, and Union Pacific either interchange freight or pass through via trackage rights. Repainted SD39s with their slugs are the locomotives that serve the switching duties here. There is also a diesel shop which can see many different road name locomotives daily from the vast number of freights that come through. The old turntable is even visible amongst the countless miles of track. With all the action and the number of railroads that visit Northtown Yard, it is no wonder why it is one of the busiest in the country. We hope you enjoyed not only the revisit of the Marshall Sub, but the extra tour to Minneapolis. Look for more professional railroading videos from the rail fan's perspective from Sioux Vision Productions coming soon.